Catechism on the Blessed Virgin Mary. We started last week. The 12 prerogatives. Prerogatives means the excellency or the privilege granted to Our Lady is only to her. Nobody else can have this kind of privilege. Therefore, it is called a prerogative. Today, I am going to tell you what are these 12 prerogatives. You may memorize it. To memorize, if you want to write down, you can write down. Or write down in your mind. You must be able to repeat, to pray. The little crown of our Blessed Mother, a small rosary, consisted of 12 Hail Marys, divided into three parts. And in between the three parts, there will be one Our Father. So three Our Father and 12 Hail Marys, composed of the rosary, the little crown of Our Lady. So try to imitate, meditate these prerogatives as much as possible. I will, in the class, Catechism, one after another I will explain. Explanation of the prerogatives will be given to you later, slowly. But you memorize this and you can begin to say the rosary. Next week when I come, I will give you each on a sheet. There, the method of saying the rosary will be given. First prerogative is Mary's predestination. What does it mean? Shortly, Our Lady was, even from all eternity, being Mother of God. That's the meaning of this predestination. Second prerogative, Mary's fullness of grace, which we have seen today, a little bit in the sermon. Fullness of grace whereby Our Lady was filled with the divine love of God. Third prerogative, Mary's divine motherhood. Divine motherhood, whereby she participated in the divine maternity of God. Fourth prerogative, Mary's immaculate conception, whereby she was the eternal procession of the divine love of God and the Son, making the third person of the Holy Trinity, Holy Ghost. And immaculate conception means procession of God's love from Father and Son. Our Lady is the spouse of the Holy Ghost. Therefore, she has all right to call herself Immaculate Conception. It's the name of the Holy Ghost. So, let us memorize these four. The first four. What are they? The predestination, fullness of grace, divine maternity, immaculate conception. Even without writing, you can memorize it. Predestination, fullness of grace, divine motherhood, immaculate conception. Second four. Fifth prerogative, Mary's intimate daughterhood of God the Father. You know already the three. Daughter of God the Father, next, virginal motherhood of God the Son, mother of God, the Son of God, and seventh, Mary's union of spousehood with the Holy Ghost, spouse of the Holy Ghost. Daughter of God the Father, mother of God the Son, spouse of Holy Ghost, and mother of all mankind. These four makes the second part. Daughter of God the Father, mother of God the Son, spouse of the Holy Ghost, mother of all mankind. Second four. Likewise, you must memorize. So the third, Mary being co-redemptrix with Jesus in saving us. When Jesus was saving us on the cross, Our Lady was also saving us, co-redemptrix. Mary being mediatrix of all graces. Co-redemptrix, mediatrix. Then two things, assumption and coronation. This is the third part. Co-redemptrix with Jesus, mediatrix of all graces, glorious assumption into heaven with body and soul, then coronation as Queen of heaven and earth. These are the prerogatives which are not given to anybody else than to our Blessed Mother. Now, we will have to all our life meditate these things. These 12 things, if we meditate always, that is enough for one to get divine love. Those who are not endowed with the gift of meditation may at least recite the little crown of the Blessed Virgin, reciting a Hail Mary in honor of the first four, one Our Father before that, in honor of God the Father, and second part, one Our Father in honor of God the Son, and four Hail Marys, second quarter, third Our Father in honor of the Holy Ghost, and four Hail Marys. Remembering these prerogatives, when we say this, it is a powerful prayer of meditation and contemplation. After learning this catechism, you will be easily able to meditate and contemplate on Our Lady far better if you attend the class regularly. Lesson 1. Before going to explain the 12 prerogatives, there is a preliminary lesson. How the Blessed Virgin Mary is united with the Holy Trinity. God the Son, God the Father. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost. How she is united. Intimately united. In the plan of incarnation, Our Lady's role with God the Father. God the Father gave His only Son to the world. And He gave His only Son through the Blessed Virgin Mary. God could have given right away the Son. But He didn't want to do that. He wanted to make use of the Mother of God. It was Mary alone who merited it and found the grace. Before God, before giving birth to the Son, there was a relation between God the Father and the Blessed Virgin Mary, though she was not born, even before she was born. We will discover ever new, the depths and beauties of the Immaculate Heart of Mary. God the Father gave only His Son, through Mary. It was she and she alone who merited it and found grace. Grace before God to receive the Son of God directly from the hands of the Father. Can you think of it? Can any man any other one, however holy, possess this prerogative. Mary was ever present before God, ever present in God, as the perfect exemplar of his own divine idea of mother, possessed in his paternity. We call the Blessed Virgin Mary, Blessed Mother of God. How? She had a share with the paternity of God the Father. That she was made mother. And it is said in the Bible, the Lord possessed me in the beginning of his ways, before he made anything from the beginning. How clear? Proverbs chapter 8. Very clearly it is said. And the church applies these words to the Holy Mother of God. The Lord possessed me, as if Our Lady says, in the beginning of his ways, before he made anything from the beginning, I was set up from eternity. So you should not think lightly about Our Lady. Our Lady was set up from eternity. It is Bible. Secondly, some saints like Mother Mary Potter, she has written a book, To Jesus Through Mary, where she says, Mary is so great that we must do as we do with God himself. Are we doing? We have to do. Must learn to do. We have to do with Mary as we do with God. She has got all the power, perfection, to claim this honor. With the fullness of God, with the fruitfulness of God, Mary stands in all eternity as a hidden world of beauty, God's secret world. This is the words of Louis de Montfort, which I already said in the sermon. When God created the angels, the angels saw Our Lady in God. That's why we are also invited to see Our Lady in God, and God in Our Lady. There is nothing wrong. When God created the angels, they saw him, this wondrous being, and exclaimed, Que est ista? Who is this? Who is this one? The good angels broke forth in admiration and began to defend the honor of God and of his holy mother. But Lucifer and his followers, the devils, conceived implacable hatred and fury against Christ and his holy mother. This became in the beginning of creation, even before man was created, immediately after the angels were created. They saw the Immaculate Conception in God. When the opportune and preordained time had arrived, God said, Now is the time to begin the work of our pleasure and to call into existence that pure creature, Mary, who is to find grace in our eyes above all the rest. God says, Let her be a most special image and likeness of our divinity. These are said as word of God by Mary of Agreda in the Mystical City of God, the book called The Mystical City of God, chapter 4. Book 1, chapter 4. God says, let her be a most special image and likeness of our divinity. We will set her apart from ordinary law, by which the rest of the mortals are brought into existence. You see, we cannot, we should not think ordinarily about Our Lady. We will set her apart from ordinary law, for in her the seed of serpent shall have no part. And God says, I will descend from heaven into her womb, and in it vest myself from her substance. From her substance with human nature. This book is written by the revelation of our Mother. Jesus and Our Lady have appeared and inspired Mary of Agreda, a Spanish woman, in the 17th century. The nature of God, nature of God's Son, God the Holy Ghost, nature of Our Lady, the life of Blessed Virgin Mary and Jesus, very elaborately revealed and written in the City of God. Now God the Son, Jesus, how He is united with the Blessed Virgin Mary. God the Son came down into her virginal womb as a new Adam into his earthly paradise to take his delight there and produce hidden wonders of grace. God the Son, who was with God the Father, Word of God, before He was born, He was Word of God. In the beginning was the Word. That Word was with God. That Word was God. That second person of the Holy Trinity, that Word of God, descended from heaven into her womb. In the year of creation, it was written in the book about 5,000 years before. In the springtime of 5th of March, at daybreak, the Blessed Virgin Mary received the message of the angel Gabriel. Finding herself in excellent condition to receive the message of God, Mary's immaculate soul was absorbed and elevated in the admiration, reverence, and highest intensity of divine love. By the intensity of these moments and supernatural affections, her immaculate heart was contracted and compressed with force. With such force that it distilled 3 drops of her most pure blood. And these blood drops, finding their way to the natural place for the act of conception, were formed by the power of the Divine and Holy Spirit into the body of Christ our Lord. That is the connection of the Blessed Virgin Mary with the Word of God, who was already there as his son, even before he was conceived in the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary. He was there, and as long as he was present as Word of God, Son of God, and Son of the Blessed Virgin Mary also. So even before he was conceived, Our Lady was the Son of, Mother of the Son of God. Thus the matter body for the holy humanity of the Word was furnished and administered by the Immaculate Heart of Mary. So Immaculate Heart is most important because it's from that heart Jesus became man. At the same time, when she pronounced fiat, let it be done, four things happened. The most holy body of our Lord was formed from the three drops of the blood. The most holy soul, which is the form of our Lord, was created. A special human soul was created. First body was created, then a human soul was created, then soul and body united. Then only he becomes perfect human. Fourth, divinity united itself with the humanity. Body and soul, humanity. Divinity is the Word of God, Son of God. The divinity of the Word of God was united with this body and soul. Together became one composite being of hypostatic union. In God, there is union of humanity and divinity, which is seen very clearly in Jesus Christ. So with that hypostatic union, the divine child began to grow in the recesses of the virginal womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, being nourished by the substance and the blood of the Most Holy Mother. Yes, all these are very elaborately written in that city of God. Thus the God-made man found freedom in imprisoning himself in the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary. He displayed power in allowing himself to be born by this young maiden. He found his glory and that of his Father in hiding his splendors from all creatures here below, and revealing them only to Mary. The divinity was revealed only to her. Jesus gave more glory to his Father by submitting to this mother for 30 years. For 30 years, he was fully subject, obedient to the Blessed Virgin Mary, through this devotion, taking Jesus as the sole model. We must also become subject to God and to the persons who represent God. I think that that will be enough for today. And God, the Holy Ghost and Mary, how they are united is very deep, elaborate, which we are going to see next week.